Hi guys, Squirrel here. Welcome back to another episode of Stranded Deep. If you remember in the last episode, we finished off by saving this shelter here. We wasn't planning on spending so much time. Oi, I saw you at the last minute, you utter scumbag. Man, I need to build a spear and nail that guy, because he's going to do that to me all day long. There's no end to his venom. I don't even know what he's living off. We wasn't planning on staying here so long, but what we did manage to do was get some barrels and build a bit of a raft. The bucket there is hopefully to collect some water. How's my water level looking? Okay, we're getting a bit low. We have got some coconut, so what I might do is have a little drink and an eat here before we set out. We kind of run out of wood and lashing on this island. There's not an awful lot here, and we've kind of used it all. Let me crack that open. So we'll take those, drink, drop, and then smash it open again. And then eat what's inside. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. I'm going to eat those anyway. We need to move. Bottom line is we need to get some more stuff because it's not here. So we can finish our raft off and then get off this island. We actually lost a flare gun as well. Don't know if I can see it anywhere in the daytime. I have a feeling it went into shallow water, but I'm not that bothered about the flare gun. There is some debate over what the flare gun is used for. Some people think it may, you know, it's going to be a component in getting rescued, which would certainly make sense. You know, maybe if you see a passing ship and you fire the flare gun, maybe that's a way to get rescued. Now, where am I going here? Let me think. There's a shark right below us. You can hear it. But hopefully it won't leave us. I'm going to go to this island here. So this is the one we've not been to. We came from over there, and as we were travelling here, if you remember, we saw this island. It's quite a way, but I'm going to try and get some stuff from it. I'm going to chop down some trees and bring it back and finish off the raft, and then maybe we'll then head back home with our fat loot, with our takings, with our captain's treasure. I can see islands, but it won't be until it snaps in that tile we'll actually get some proper detail on what's on this island. I can see a lot of beach as well, actually. I need to learn which shark it is that leaves you alone and which one goes for you, because it's going to be important when we go for diving. It's going to be very important to know if I'm going to get bit or not. From my experience of going in the water with sharks, they tend to swim around and annoy you and scare you, but they don't tend to attack you so much. There you go, it just snapped in. Okay, the good news is I can see a lot of palm trees, which essentially means we can get the wood that we need. Let me just make sure we know how to get back. There it is. That's what it looks like. I'm going to leave the dinghy on the island pointing back to the one that we just came from. And on that island, we've got a shelter pointing back to the base island. Ultimately, what I'd like to do is build a shelter here that points back to the one we're coming from. So it kind of builds up a link of shelters that always point the way back to home, effectively. And so we get a compass and we can actually start drawing a map and figuring out where we are and how to get between things. That's about the best we can do. I'm just kind of looking around just to make sure I can't see any bubbles, but no shipwrecks so far. But at least 5 or 6 palm trees just on this island, which is really cool. Yucca plants are also what we need. This is a nice beach. Look at this. Okay, that's where we came from. So I'm going to leave that here, well out of the water, and like that. That's where we need to go. Right, what have we got on the island? Let's have a quick look. It's a very nice island, actually. I see something over there, which might be a shipwreck. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get to work here. Our axe is looking a bit low as well. We'll get to work here and get the wood that we need. What are we carrying here? Okay, stuff. One wood stick. Love you. Love you. Definitely need these guys for the lashing. Once we've built the the raft, it actually moves you quite a bit quicker as well than the life raft. Once we build our own, it goes nice and quickly. We do need a piece of tarp for the sail, but we've already got a piece of tarp. But again, a lot of this stuff is held together by lashing, so we do need to get... Come here, you. You're very useful. We do need to get lots of this stuff, as well as wood. And then we'll have to transport back. And because we built a shelter over there, we can actually rest as well. Water is going to be the main thing that we need to watch for. Unless it rains, because I have a bucket with servings of water. And water's not terrible at the moment, but it can become critical if you don't, you know, don't pay attention. Let me drive you over here. Okay, you can sit there. We'll get another one. No, don't climb it, pal. Don't climb it. Yeah, once we've got the raft going, it'll actually make adventuring a bit easier because it'll be a lot more stable and a lot quicker. Get that. The only thing about this kind of deforestation is it's you've obviously got to be careful, because if you do too much of it, you know, especially these young palm trees, they won't then grow into bigger palm trees which you need later. So you can't just go around doing this indefinitely. It is a little mini ecosystem, and you do need to allow it to grow back. Right, that's that. Now, we have got enough stuff here that we could, in theory, build, as I say, a shelter if we need to, but we don't want to do that because I'll have to use lashing. Come on. Right, let's get this bit. This is definitely going to wear out the axe, you know. I'm a bit worried. We're going to need to make another axe. Oh, we've actually got one, haven't we? Hang on. We've actually got another axe. Yes, we have. We found one. We're all good then. This is the only sort of slightly grindy part here where you have to kind of hack everything down, but at least when you've built your raft, at least when you've built your raft, it makes you feel like you've earned it, you know? You kind of feel proud because you're like, I made that. You know, I sat there, I chopped all those trees down, I chopped it into logs, and I fashioned myself a raft. Which I think is kind of cool. I'd like to find some more, shipwrecks. Speaking of which, you know what, I might quickly, what time is it? I might quickly have a run over here, because I am kind of curious as to what that is. I think it's a shipwreck. This is beautiful here, look at this. Lovely, like, shallow areas. Some more tarp here as well. Ooh, corrugated scrap. Very useful. No! Okay, hang on. What we can do is we can convert some lashing. Just to help pack things down a bit. Cool. Right, so pick four of them up. They'll stack. Should allow us to pick that up. And we've got two slots left. The corrugated scrap will stack. That's, I think, four. Four stacks nicely. There's some more over there. There's another tarp. Hello there. What could be in here? Oh, wow. Are you kidding me? Are you actually kidding me? Wait, it's raining. Let me get out of here. That is the most disappointing moment ever. Okay, what we can do is we can... One, two, three. Crouch down. And that will fill up. Yeah, that's ridiculous. How can I find a container with nothing in it? Like, wherever it came from, the doors were sealed. So, whatever the contents were, I was expecting some lovely Nike trainers inside. And maybe a Wilson ball, you know, the kind of stuff that you can't find on your island. That's unbelievable. I suppose you could live in it, but you can't move it, can you? I can't drag that. I physically can't move it. I can't hit it. Oh, yeah, I can. Hang on. I wonder if it'll break up. You what, mate? A door. Oh, wow. I've just broken a door off. What the heck is going on? Can I actually... Wait, can I use that? Let's go to the building a second. Let's go to homes. Doors. Corrugated door. Container door. A pair of doors salvaged from a shipping container. Shipping containers do not require an arch to place and occupy one wall position. Well, I never knew that. Is there anything else you can make? Steel door. So basically you can nick the container door. What about the walls? Can you use those? Corrugated wall. Container wall. A wall made from salvaged scrap can be used to enclose an area. Flip an egg. So, okay, hang on. So I can just smack on this and break it down into walls and doors. That's actually quite cool. I like that mechanic. Can I move it yet? No. Why are you not hitting? Oh, there we go. This is hilarious. I have no chance of getting this stuff back home, but I feel compelled to do this. So I could build a second home just made out of a container. There it goes. Come on. Of course, I'd need a base. Like a floor. There's a shipwreck there, look. You see it? Or something. There's something out there. Hang on. Let me get my... Let me put the scrap down. I've got too much stuff, guys. This is quickly unfolding into something I did not plan. Which is not good. I'm going to get caught out if I'm not careful. But I can't just not do anything about this. I can't leave these things. I really would like a spear, you know. What time is it? 15:01. Okay, sun's going down in about an hour and a half. I need to be quick. You watch me get eaten by a shark now. I think it's a wreck. I don't know, actually. All I can see is a little boxy bit. It's definitely not... Oh, it is. Oh, my God. It is. Is that two... No, it's not two of them. At least it's capsized so I can get on it. There's one there as well. Oh, my God. No, this is like Loot Island. And I'm here on a poxy little life raft and have no shelter. I might have to build a shelter. Okay, right. Well, barrels. Of course we find barrels. Why not make it more impossible for me? Empty. Are you kidding me? Okay, barrels. What else have we got? Let's go in here. More barrels. Oh, man. It's compelling me to build the most... Machete. The most epic... Come on. A torch and a propeller. Let me get some air. Okay, you can actually get some air from here. Right, back in. Need to do this before it goes dark. What's in here? A jerry can. Nothing in there. That's pretty wrecked. Nothing that way. Let's get the old air. One last look, just to make sure. Nope, 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 nope. What's that? Nothing. Bubbles coming from there, as if what? As if there's something down there? Is that what the bubbles mean? Nope, can't see anything. Probably stayed a bit too long. Okay, well, we found some stuff. Including barrels that we can't actually get hold of. Uh-oh, that is the sound of a shark. Ripperoni on toast. Oh my god, go away! Go away! Leave me alone, leave me alone. I'll kick you in the face, bro. I promise I'll kick you in the face. Ooh, dear. Okay, so there are 6 barrels on that, and there's another one. There's a container that we're still breaking down. There's corrugated metal. This has just turned into a bit of a problem. Because I can't survive here right now. I don't have enough water and stuff. Pick up the planks as well. We might as well. This is a deceiving little island, this one. It looks like there should be nothing here, but there's actually an awful lot of stuff here. There are trees, though. I could make a shelter. What is that in the water? That's not my raft, is it? Please tell me that's not... That can't be my raft. My raft's over there. Hang on. Oh, my God. And it's going dark. Jerry can. Propeller. Planks of wood. Let's go over here before it goes dark. My bucket. Let's get the machete out. I can kill anything with my machete of doom. It's another shipwreck. That's like 3 on this island. If I'm really quick. Oh no, there's those little boy things, look. Look at that. It's got those little, you know I was telling you about, that you can make stuff out of as well. It's got those on it. What's in here? Propeller. Come on, find a compass. How many propellers do we need? Another torch. Are you kidding me, game? Is there anything on the roof? Come on, what do you get? Nothing on the roof, nothing on the bow. Okay, we might as well take these. Don't know if we'll use them. I guess we should use them. They look kind of cool. Not sure if the machete is the best thing for the job, to be honest. There we go. Right. Oh, we can pick these up. That's handy. That's very, very handy. Unlike the barrels. Is that planks? No. Where's the torch gone? All 3 of them. Let's get off. Right. Yeah. And I still haven't broken up the container, and we probably need to sleep soon, and I'm running out of water, and we have no shelter here. Woo! I feel like the man who just struck gold, but is unable to go anywhere with it, you know? Okay, let me put my machete down a second. Now, I really wish I had a lantern right now, rather than a torch. Because what we could really do with is a fire. Which I could probably make. I don't really have much wood on me. Oh man, let's put the rocks down. Let's get the torch so we can actually see what's going on. I have 3 torches. This is just insane. But they stack, so there's no point putting them on the ground. Right, we're going to have to make a campfire, guys, because we need to see what we're doing here. And... yeah, we've got 3 bars of sleep left. And it's 6:30, which means if I... put it this way. If I work through the night, I'm going to have to sleep through the day. And I don't really want to do that. Ideally, I'd sleep now, but that would mean making a shelter. Ay, 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 ay. First world problems. Right, let's grab a palm tree. Let's grab a palm tree. I apologize if you can't see anything. I don't have a lantern. We'll just have to look at the moonlight and then drag this thing over here. But yeah. I have no way of saving on this island. Actually, thinking about it, thinking about this, let's drag this palm tree back over here to where we landed. And we'll make the shelter there, because that way it will point back to where we're coming from. I hope he's still got hold of this. This guy's amazing. He's dragging a palm tree through the water. I mean, seriously. Right, there's the other two. We have some lashing on us. We've got some wood here. If we go for shelter, what are we missing? Palm leaves. Okay, well, that's easily done because we just need to smack the end off one of these things. That'll let us save and sleep, and then we can drink in the morning, and then we've got a whole day of stuff. But frankly, getting these things back is going to be tricky. Like, those barrels, I need to rescue them, but it's not worth doing it until we bring the raft over here, because then I can build them onto the existing raft. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful. Whoa. Was you here before? I would have thought I would have cut you down if you was here before. That's weird. Okay, so the island is back that way somewhere. Palm leaf. I'm missing a palm leaf. You little... Right. That way is the way to go, so we're going to build this. Here-ish. Doesn't really matter exactly where. Let's see. It was about there, wasn't it? So, as long as it's pointing back, I don't want it wonky like that. I want it nice and... Yay! That's a good first move, because now we're out of the danger zone a little bit, because we can sleep and save. What about a little fire? A little campfire, which we can make out of some sticks. Now, a campfire would be useful back here on the hill. Like that. Let's chop some more wood down. Actually, we've got some wood here, haven't we? So, we can build a... Not a lashing, a... Kindling. And... Oh, we had a load of rocks back there, couldn't we? What's the food level like? Food level's fine. I was just thinking about making a proper fire. We've got rocks on us. We could probably upgrade the fire now. Hang on. Campfire. Yeah, we can. We've got the rocks. Let's just upgrade this guy. And then that way we can always just stick wood back on it to keep it going kind of thing. So what we'll do now is light the fire and then we can actually see a bit better what's going on. Well, this is crazy, guys. This has turned out to be not what I expected at all. If you think the previous island, I was thinking, oh, you know, we found these things, we can build ourselves a raft. Came here, quite literally, just to get some more wood. And we end up finding, like, insane amounts of stuff. Now, I'm going to sleep purely because I want to make it the morning. So... Because I don't want to have to sleep through the daytime. That would suck. So I'm going to save. And then I'm going to sleep. There we go. Beautiful. It's the morning. Yay. The fire's still burning. We'll leave the fire. We don't mind. Okay. Right. Water situation is not good. So what we'll do is we'll grab the bucket. Now, I'm going to leave the bucket stood upright over here, like that. Just move it a little bit. Like that. And the reason I'm going to do that is so that A, I'm not carrying it round, and B, if it does happen to rain today, that's going to fill up. Otherwise, our only source of water is the coconuts that we're carrying around, these guys here, which I'll also leave. We should hydrate us a little bit. But they're more of a diminishing return kind of hydration. What else can we... Whoa. Where are you going? Where are you going? Do you even physics? Squeeze me. Have you ever heard of grass friction? Yeah, there you go. You sit there. What do we need to carry around with this? Right, let's go back and fashion some more stuff. From over here. You see, ideally I'd like to take all this stuff back to base and use it to build our house. But those sheets of metal, oh my god, I don't know how we're going to move those back. Even if with a big raft, they're pretty heavy, I imagine. If we stick those on the back of a raft, it's probably going to sink. So I don't even know if we can. So we're a little bit stuck, if I'm honest with you. Right, we've got all this. Let's just get the rest of this off the container, because what I don't want... I don't know if these things despawn, but I don't really want it despawning on me. Nor do I know if you can take the base off this. Let's find out. There it goes. Come on, off you come, pal. Over here. There we go. You still have to build a floor, though, that's the thing. What is that? Is that wood? It's a container floor made out of wood. How bizarre. Come on. Did that just fall off? I think it did. Yes, it did. Still surviving in our shirt and tie. Right, you sit there. The amount of stuff we've found, though. I mean, I think we found, what, 4 propellers? Which is a bit annoying, actually. We've got the carburetor. We've got the propeller. We've got the jerry can. Actually, what do we need for an engine? I think there's 4 pieces that we need. Carburetor, propeller, jerry can, and... the actual engine block, I think. I think you need the actual engine block. That's the bit. I don't think we have the engine block yet. Right, is there anything left on here that we can... this? No. I think we've stripped it. We appear to have stripped it. Now, the barrel's over there. I don't want to release and carry 6 barrels back. So what I'm thinking is, with regards to the barrels... here's what I'm thinking. If we look at the build menu a second, the bases, to build a barrel scrap thing requires 2 lashing and the barrels. Which means if I take 4 lashing with me to that point there, I can instantly build a piece, right? Do you get where I'm coming from here? So what I'm trying to say is, if I get the lashing and take our existing raft and go over there, we can build it. So I'm going to leave all this stuff here, because we don't need to take all this with us. I might take that with me, though. We don't need to take all this with us. We don't need the rocks either. We just need some more lashing and a lot of wood. And the reason we need a lot of wood is because when I go back to the island here, we need to build another section of the... are there any more yucca plants here? We need to build another section of the base. Why am I stuck? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab all the lashing I can, then get a whole lot of wood. We're going to go back to the other island. We're going to build one more section of floor. One more section of base, sorry. Just keep finding stuff. This island's insane. And then we're going to come back here and extend it using that barrel. And it's going to look amazing. Physics. It's going to genuinely look cool. Finding so many barrels is... well, I've never seen that before. That means we can have barrels all down the length of our raft. And it's just going to look incredible. But we also need to build a sail for it. Which is going to require tarp, which we have. And probably more lashing, which we're going to need. So we're going to need lots of this stuff. Wow, the floating palm tree. The next iteration in the palm tree genetics evolution is the floating palm tree. And I just cut it off, which means I ended the next evolution of the palm tree right there, just to use it for a bit of lashing. GG. Another coconuts, we'll ignore that for now. If it's going to rain, I'd kind of like it to do it right now, to be honest. Because I'd like that bucket filled up. I don't worry about the food level, but I do worry about the water level. It's very... if you've not got the right setup, your water level goes down so quickly. But the food and the sleep, as you've probably noticed, doesn't go down that quickly. And water is pretty hard to come by if you've not got the stuff to make it. And when you do have stuff to make it, it comes pretty slowly. Just making sure we've got enough of this stuff. I do not want to run out. Another one! Another floating iteration, and I've just destroyed it. Okay, right, let's convert this stuff into lashing. How much have we got? We've got quite a bit of it now. We're going to need quite a bit of it. Because these things will stack. I need one more to make an extra one. You'll do! This is going to be so cool, guys, honestly. All this grinding, but it'll be so worth it. We're going to have an amazing raft. Right, there we go. So now I'm going to flick back to my crude axe, and we're going to hack these guys down into logs. What time is it? It's only 11 o'clock in the morning. That's cool. We've got plenty of time. We'll hack this lot down, and then we're going to take a trip back and build the raft out a little bit more. And then we're going to come back and build it out a bit more again. And then we're going to have an amazing raft to go around on. And then we're going to die of dehydration because I didn't take care of the water. It's raining. Nice. Perfect timing. I don't happen to have another log, do I? Another bucket, I don't. That's a good thing. That means when we set out, it won't rain. Because one of the bad things that can happen, I've noticed, is you get on your raft, you set out, it's a beautiful day, and then all of a sudden it rains, and you find yourself, you can't even see the island where you're going, and you pretty much can't see where you came from either. And if you're not careful, you get disoriented. When that happens, you can end up in the wrong direction. You don't know where you are, you see an island, you don't know where it is, you don't know the way back. And all that stuff that you built somewhere is pretty much lost until you can find it again, and all because it rained at the wrong time. Well, I'm not sure how much we're going to need. We're going to need at least 15 for one midsection piece. But I think maybe if we take as much as we can. How much slots have we got? Okay, we could take quite a bit as it happens. It's not worth setting out until it's finished raining anyway, so I'm happy to just pack away here. I must admit, the visuals in this game and the sound effects are just, they're really nice. Like, it feels like it's raining. The sound of rain, I do like the sound of rain anyway. It's just lovely. I kind of like some thunderstorms, some proper, you know, thunder cracking in, some lightning. It would be nice at some point if they brought in proper storms, and I think they will. Like, if I was building this game, I'd already be thinking about how strong these components are, you know, how durable things are, with a view to making stuff that, have I got my hammer? I do. With a view to making stuff that, you know, if a storm lands, it's just not going to last if I've built it out of driftwood. If a really big storm lands, even my wooden stuff's going to get damaged, but if I made it out of containers or whatever, then I'll be fine. Like steel, fine. Right, that looks full, so I'm just going to pick that up. Let me put the... that there. I'm going to take a drink. Put it back down again. It's now empty, so it only had two in it. But it's filled up, fill me up on the water, which will keep me going. We'll kind of leave that there to flush out. I am going to save it, and then we're going to head out in a second that way. It should stop raining very soon. Okay, physics. There we go. There's the island. All aboard. Let's go. Double check. Yep, we're heading away from the where the shelter's pointing. But yeah, just look outside. The visuals of this. I mean, I remember. I've seen games You know, water started out as just this kind of blue thing. And then we had the blue thing with animations of bits of, you know, water crashing up at the waves. Eventually we got to a point where we started to generate waves in computer graphics, and it kind of looked like it was moving properly, but it never looked real. But if you look at that water now, well, it's pretty convincing, I will say that. Even the color of it is tropical. It's so good. The clouds, I'd say the clouds are decent. They're not amazing or anything. I've seen better. They look a little bit too irregular for me. Like, the shape of them is a bit too, I don't know. It just doesn't look right. But I can't, you know, in terms of land visuals, I can't fault it really. I think it looks amazing. You get derpy physics now and again with the floating items, and as you saw, stuff pings off every now and again to the distance, but this Unity engine, I think it's a Unity 5 engine, is so good. Please let this be the island, because if it's not, I have no idea where I am. Okay, there's a shipwreck, I think it is. Yeah, I'm pretty certain we headed off at an angle from that shipwreck. Yep, and the base is back towards the left. So worst case scenario, we could probably hop from one island to another in one day. You know, if things got really, really desperate, we could head back and get water. Because back at base, it's going to be pretty much two buckets full of water. Right, let me... Okay, that's where we came from. So let's make sure we know how to get there. There it is. And then over here should be, if the calculations are right, should be the raft. Okay, there's the tarp. We're going to need that. Yay! Right, barrels. Oh, bucket of water. I forgot about that one. I totally forgot we left that. Okay, let's drop this wood. Okay, we have to drop the knife first. We'll drop this wood over here. Okay, please stop pinging off like that. You have to kind of keep moving as you drop it. Otherwise, it hits the one that's already moving, and that's when the physics like that seems to go a little bit... Let's get my knife back. Right, there's some tar. There's some barrels. We want... Now, thinking about this, we're gonna be building two more of those components, which are going to sit here and here. So we've kind of got a choice now. If we're going to build another one of these sections, then the problem is, in order to build the two barrel sections, we're going to have to build another two of those. Oh, man. But if we only have it one wide, it's going to look a bit weird. And I don't think I've got enough wood to build three foundation sections. Like, that is a lot of wood. Let's have a look. Bases. Yeah, there you go. They're 15 each, and I've got 42, which means I've almost got enough to build three. So, like, I could snap that one on there like that. Tell you what, let me pick that up before I end up dropping it or knocking it flying and then wasting an awful lot of water. Here's my lanterns. I should have one over here as well. Okay, there he is. Might have to take one of those with me next time. We can probably find three wood, hopefully, on the beach somewhere. If not, because I don't think a tree will have grown back. Let's get the axe out. There's also a snake around here somewhere. Is that choppable? Yes, okay. Hello! Hello, Mr. Snake. You friendly? Because I'm not, pal. As soon as I built a spear, you're having it. You've bit me one too many times. Okay, I think we've got enough. Having said that, I need to... I actually got some wood here. I need wood for the mast as well. Right. Okay, now can we build our other barrel? Yes, we can. So we build that on the side. This is really taking shape now. This is it. You do a whole lot of grinding and then all of a sudden it just starts to look amazing as it comes together. Look at this. We're going to have, like, the raft to end rafts. Especially if we can build an engine at some point. That's going to look amazing. Okay, Right, now the other barrel pieces, as you know, are going to be built later. But we are going to need a sail. This will not go anywhere without propulsion. So we're going to need a tarp sail. Now, weirdly enough, this kind of snaps into one position. But in order to put it on, you need a floor. You can't just put that on the base. You actually need a floor piece. So we're going to have to chop down that tree and build a piece of floor now. Otherwise, I mean, the thing will float. It's just that you can't attach anything without a floor piece. But I think we can get away with one floor piece. It may be slightly off weight, though, off center. But we'll see what happens. Let's chop that one as well. I sense the evening coming. We have got a shelter here, so we could, in theory, save it before we head back and carry on. Okay, let's have a look. A hammer. Floors. Right, now you can build floors out of wood. You can also build them out of steel scraps. Anything you like, really. We're just going to go for some wooden floor. Like that. And I think we can hopefully... Can we not attach that? Hang on. What does it say about that? Sail made from tarp. This component needs to be placed on top of a raft floor. This component can be used to add propulsion to raft. Okay, that's weird, because I just did add it on top of a raft floor. What's wrong with that then? Okay, I'm still out of range of the tarp. Yeah, engine and engine canister, they're the only things we're missing here. There you go, there you go. I had it then. I actually had it then. You have to put it higher, that's what it is. That's what it is, there you go. It looks a bit rubbish, if I'm honest. But it's going to do the job. I don't think I've got enough wood left now, have I, for floor? Oh yeah, I have one more. Put one more down, then we can balance it at least. There you go. So we've balanced that with a bit of floor. We're now in a position where we can actually sail that back. But annoyingly, it's getting nighttime, right? 1742. We've also got all these lovely, expensive and useful components that are left on the floor here. We should have another lantern there. Let's see what else. Is there anything else that we hear that we actually need to take with us? Otherwise, we're kind of done here. Okay, let's move this. Now, you got to be careful. It will kind of catch on the... Like that, you see. It will kind of catch on the rocks and do crazy things. Right. So, if we can see that island, we could head out at night. It is a risk, but we can try it. So we jump on. And hold E. And where are we going? Wow, it's so hard to see. Okay, this thing's not turning. Turn! Turn, we're going the wrong way. I'm going to get lost. Reverse gear. Okay, this thing is... Hold on a minute. So it's kind of sailing the wrong way for me. I think what's happening is to do with the way that it's pointing. I don't know if I had any control over that, but I actually wanted it to sail in that direction, and it appears to be steering... Hang on, maybe I can do it now. No, it's kind of steering in that direction, look. So it means we're going that way, which is not really what I wanted, if I'm honest. Okay, can I actually see the island or not? Because... I don't feel like I can see it very well. Oh, but the shark's here. He's seeing me. Oh, there it is. Hang on, there it is. Is this the right way? There's the thing. Oh my god, I'm getting like... I'm stuck on this now. I'm stuck on a bit of coral. Let me get back over here. It's amazing the speed this thing has a reverse gear on it. There we go. Right. We're heading towards the moon. There's the island. Travel at night is definitely not recommended. I just got spun around. I'm not sure if it was a bit of coral or the shark just had a go at me. YOLO! Here we go! Right, now the good thing is this thing will actually outrun the shark once it gets going. There we go. It is actually quite nippy. Now, as you can see as well, it's way more stable. I mean, seriously, way more stable. Look how much we're not bobbing around. And that makes it a lot easier to spot those bits in the water, you know? But in terms of steering, it's doing some really derpy stuff. I presume it's because it's a bit off-centre in terms of weight. You know, because it's only got a bit of floor, and not all the floor. It's either that or I put the sail on wrong. It's kind of steering in a very strange fashion. So I'm going to have to fix that. I'm actually having to hold the left key right now. But look how quick it is and how stable. It's like gliding across the water. Of course, this is where we find out I've come to a completely wrong island. That'll be GG if I have. Nope, there's a shelter. I was a little bit worried for a minute there. Here we go. Okay. Let's drag that away. So it's good. It's not perfect. It needs the other barrels on it, and it needs a proper section of floor on it, and we may, if that doesn't fix it, we may have to knock the sail off the top and build it again, because right now it's just not steering really well at all. But we made it back over here. We've probably got a bucket full of water there. Have we got any wood on us? Yes, we have. So we'll change to the wood. Put that down. We don't really need to build a campfire, if I'm honest. We'll just do this. Like I say, the lanterns are wonderful. Water levels aren't that low. We have a bucket of fresh water. We can also eat some coconuts and stuff. So we're actually doing well. Considering we're quite away from home here, we're actually doing pretty well. Let's put that there. So I'm going to go and save. And I think we're done here for another episode. What we're going to do... What's our sleep level like? What we're going to do is we're going to work through the night here, I think. And in the next episode, we're going to work through the night. And we're going to go over to where the other barrels are. I've got, I think, lashing. Have I got lashing? I've got one piece. We need another piece of lashing. Actually, we need more. Because to build the base, we need... Do we want to put the life buoys on or not? Wood, barrel. We need two pieces of lashing to attach two more of those barrel things on to here and here, which we can do either side. But we need one more piece of lashing, which is fine. We can easily do that. That's what we're going to do next, and then we'll see about fixing up this thing so that it's nice and stable and quick. That's it for this episode of Stranded Deep. I do hope you enjoyed that. Please give me a thumbs up if you did. And until next time, happy surviving.